Okay, hello, welcome back. I'm gonna play the third part of Ocarina of Time now. I think I'm gonna do the bottom of the well and the water temple today. It's probably not gonna be that long of a stream. So, but I guess I'm just gonna have to go and see you. So, let's go. Okay. Still haven't figured out the control scheme. So this is on PC, the Ship of Harkinian project, I guess. And it's only 60 FPS, apparently. Pretty sweet. Joystick drift on the right stick still. Actually, if I want to do what with the world, I have to child link. For some reason, the controller is vibrating now permanently. To the riding speed? Yeah, that's weird. Yep, that's weird. Well, that's interesting, okay. The original Ocarina of Time on N64 only had a rumble on if you had the rumble pack. So I guess they restored that function, but it's not very balanced. It triggers constantly for no good reason. That's fine, I guess. So I watched the second episode of Star Trek Strange New Worlds, or at least partway through. Pretty good, I have to say. I haven't watched Discovery or... Actually, I did watch the first season of Discovery. And... Oh, wait a minute, I'm gonna shut up. I mean, yeah. You destroyed the wicked creatures that haunted the temple and awakened the sage. But there are still other sages who need your help. In order to awaken all the other sages, you must become even more powerful. You must travel over mountains, underwater, and even through with time. If you want to return to your original time, return the Master Sword to the Pedestal of Time. By doing this, you will travel back in time 7 years. A time will come when you will have to return here quickly. I will teach this to you for when that time comes. The song to return you to the Temple of Time, the Prelude of Light. She just stares amazed.
Whoa. Ouch.
But she just straight up vanished then. That's interesting. Just stupid. Completely lost what the plot was about. couldn't really follow along. Then again, I wasn't really paying that much attention. I guess it just lost me, kinda. What else did I watch? I guess. What's his name?
Loki.
Yeah, the Loki show. There were a couple of other parts, but otherwise it was pretty good actually. Funny when that continues. Walking backwards. Come back to normal speed. Done the chicken side quest with the water bottle. I guess we've already done. We've done and failed the dumpy, getting the dumpy's piece of heart. And I don't really feel like doing it again, or trying to do it again. Very cool and very unique models, but strange. You can just walk in there. Very atmospheric. About this place. Then again, I don't think it's that complicated actually. Let's go in here. So actually, a lot of hits. So wasn't there some kind of secret? If we destroy that bonus, or do we even wear that one? Nothing at all. still going here. So with the break of the sun, or the what am I, composer brothers, the bottom of the well and the shadow temple all being this close to each other. What's going on in here? This dude have a navel. The navel is on backwards. What the hell, man? What the hell? Oops. Being killed by this is an item we needed. Trying. Didn't take that long. half an hour. Or maybe a bit longer, yeah, a bit longer. Okay, nothing. Sorry, nothing. Oh yeah. What a weird room. I think you can set these dudes on fire, huh? Give it a try. Maybe you have to use fire arrows. Ah, that's what how it works. Yikes. Guess let's just trigger all encounters at once. Full of bats. Lots of spin attacks to get rid of everything.
Ha ha ha!
stick jumping attack. And his body remains twitching. What a great detail. Snap down that dark tunnel, but it's a, some kind of texture supposed to represent well. Okay. Technically, we could already leave, but I think there's a piece of object there. So let's rather not do that joke. Let's just leave it on that. Just as a very interesting this time. Oh yeah, I can just gyro for sure. Not that I can have a character. Okay. Wow. Very, very cool. Any actual good reason why you should go in there?
Sure.
it. There's still that thing. Hmm. Cool. Whatever. Take a look down there. Whatever. Let's just leave. Sure, it's nothing important. Just play the song now and go to the Temple of Time. There we go. So, time travel never really made sense. Or you could just randomly travel back and forth. If you think through it, think it through. How it's supposed to work. Actually, the entire story doesn't really make that much sense. I mean, stopping gambling in the future doesn't really do anything for the past. And since the goal is to prevent this future, it's kind of pointless actually. The entire quest is completely pointless. So, if you hear a background noise, that's the controller permanently rumbling while Epona is riding at speed. That's kind of a weird feature. There we go. Oh yeah, you have to go. Oh, I completely forgot. You have to go to do the ice. The ice, not dungeon. Ice thingy first. It's been like 10 years since I last played this, so completely smooth brain lad. Gyro is really useful. Usually that one is a real pain in the ass to hit. Okay. So some things I remember, others like the general sequence of the dungeons I've completely forgotten. It's kind of weird. There's a ghost over here, I think. Yeah, there we go. Weird. I'm full on rupees. Would be kind of a waste. Painful. Do you need rupees for anything? Probably not, right? I don't think we need rupees, so let's just sell this stuff. Whoops. Check in with the ghost dude. Slash. potential pimp or something like that. Oh, and we need the blue tunic and the iron boots as well. I've completely forgotten about that. Yep. You guys haven't been too kind to the soldier during this thing. Yeah. Oh, it's been rough. okay. Yeah, actually helps the world gets even worse. So he gets can collect more ghosts. That's great. Oops, sorry, I didn't want to kill you. Oh, I have to give him a drink, okay. There we go. Oh. Come on, can we skip this? What the hell? Separately. Did they fix that in the 3DS version? I'm not sure actually, I haven't played it. I own it, but I haven't played it. Ocarina of Time is a great game, but there's a lot of clunk going on. A lot of McClunkies. Come on. Oops. Oh well. Go from here. Oh, there's another ghost. I completely missed out on. There's the frog. Frog side quest. I think there's Childlink. You have to play all the songs, or maybe just the Song of Storms. And they give you a piece of heart. Okay. bad. I scout you, not bad. No evil is. I think it's on that ladder, actually, isn't it? Not that much. Isn't it? Nope. Nope, nope, nope. Okay. Weird inaccurate memories. Oops, wrong sound. There we go. Was that timing, or is that connected to playing the song? The daybreak. Oh, having 4 bottles would have been useful for keeping the blue flames, but I guess too late. Didn't get them. So I don't think you actually need them, but they might be convenient. Oh well. Probably fine. Ah, that noise is nice. How do you clap? Oh, nice. Come on, get up there. But do we have to swim all the way to the start? Okay. That's weird. Okay, I think there's another piece of heart at the bottom of the lake when you have the iron boots, if I remember correctly. So. Yeah. Now, these guys also show up in boxes. They're way more annoying. Ice spears. They look kind of different actually. They don't look anything like them. They actually just have in common that they're also made of ice. So silly. Ah, there we go. That's the last. Did we come from here? I think we came from here. Yep. So it goes along swimming in the circle. Yeah, it just respawns the icicles. Isaac mites. Isaac mites. Doesn't really matter. Isn't there like a slimy pot person in here? There's also a shop in the Violet Princess in the... How am I supposed to be? Come on, turn it out. Guess we'll shoot them. Come on. Okay. Okay. That would have taken way longer. Standard. Ah, there's a blue flame here. Let's fill up. Yep. Blue fire. Actually sure which things you have to unfreeze. Yeah, probably this. Although it's probably just the map. But I guess it doesn't work on the map. Which leads to the bossing or something? With the wolf? Like an ice wolf mini boss? Yikes. Oh yeah, are there chests that freeze you in this dungeon? Freezes. Give it a try. And here we go. This is the slime block puzzle. Unlike the fire bats, these frozen bats don't lose their frost effect when they hit your shield. New enemies are usually tougher than red ones. Zelda, that's a thing. First Zelda game, and I guess in Breath of the Wild as well. Blue enemies are always tougher than the red ones. Oh, and fire. Okay. Now she's freaking out. Anything there? Nope. Send a refresh. So I guess I completely exaggerated with having to get 4 bottles. Or at least that's what I say right now. I haven't actually done this. Oh, that's another silver key. Okay. Last one. Can't move while the thing slides. Yep. Save us up some time. And completely bungle it there. Okay, let's just reset. Okay. that's out of the floor. Okay. That's the last of the silver. I guess we have to reset another once again. And how do we do this? Just push it here. Not gonna fit through there, right? Let's give it a try, I guess. Oh yeah, goes through, okay. I'm sure there was a similar puzzle in one of the Pokemon games. That is probably not good. In a weird space room. And we win against the mini boss, and that's it. Very cool. You wasted your time. Okay. This is all there is, with one exception. The doors are now sealed under this thick ice sheet. Thick ice sheet. I managed to rescue the Zora princess from under the ice, but she lived to head for the Watertemple. This ice is created by an evil curse. The monster in the Watertemple is the source of the curse. Unless you shut off the source, this ice will never melt. If you have courage enough to confront the danger and save the Zoras, I will teach you the melody that leads to the temple. Time passes, people. And then we get the philosophical part. That's always in this dialogue. Childish mind will turn to noble ambition, young love will become deep affection, the clear water surface reflects growth. Now listen to the serenade of water to reflect upon yourself. With all the band-aids on her fingers. Practiced too much. Oh yeah, space. What is this room supposed to be? So we need water, okay. Oh, okay, yes. Oh dear, okay, I forgot, okay. There we go, okay. I played a... Oh no, it wasn't even you played it. Oh yeah, that ROM hack. Some ROM hack, I'm not exactly sure, one of the kinda edgier ones, had the ability to put the iron boots onto the D-pad, one of the D-pad buttons, which drastically sped up the equipping and unequipping part. So, I guess that's gonna be a pain in the ass. Oh yeah, we have to take one fire for the king, pretty sure. I'm gonna have to stock up for a workout. Okay, and a piece of trapped or something along those lines. These treasure chests. I guess not. Nope. It's just untrapped. Countess. And. Oh, this one too. Scotchula. Sink to the bottom of the lake and unfreeze that to Zora King. Something like that. Yeah, 1 minute and 50 seconds. 15 seconds. There we go. It would be probably better if they played some tense sonic drowning music. But I guess you can't have everything. Oh, he sure takes his time getting back to the surface. Have to go to the fairy fountain a second time? I don't think so. But I'm not actually sure. No, I don't know what the difference. Yeah. Hey dude, what's up? Don't be nervous. Oh, he doesn't recognize us, so that's why. Okay. Okay, so now we just can play. We can just play the Serenade of Water and run away instantly. There we go. Yep. Oh, it's raining. I think that's random, isn't it? I'm not sure, actually. Okay. It always sounds like he says shit when he says that. Only when he makes that noise. Okay, now for the universally beloved water temple. I hope I'm gonna be able to finish this. Alright. But I have gotten stuck numerous times in this temple. I hope it's not gonna be frustrating nightmare. I haven't looked at a walkthrough or anything, so I guess bear with me. Let's first look before we do anything. Okay. I see. Are you supposed to do something with that shooting target to push this block to the left? This temple is so disorienting is that everything looks very similar, that you constantly change water levels, which change the part where you can go and where you can't go, and that there's just a lot of rooms, a lot of branching rooms. Made worse by the fact that it takes a while to sink and swim and move around with iron boots. Everything is slow because we have to go to the menu to change. So yeah, this is great dungeon. No, but really, it really is a great dungeon. Bombs. Don't do that while underwater. I've played through this temple like 5 times already, and I'm still not entirely sure. Oh, there we go. Thank you. Oh yeah, I forgot. Okay. Whatever. Oh, they're dying. I didn't actually remember that. So, the theory that the sages are dead makes sense for Saria and Darunia, I guess. But there's actually no reason why she should be dead. I mean, she just floats up there, and then she's dead, supposedly. I guess that's one reason. It's kind of weird. And dead. Never arrived yet. Okay, I think we have to play the song. Played through this, where he gets comboed by these clam enemies, comboed to death in that very narrow passageway underwater. Okay, I don't think there's anything here. Just a weird texture. Supposed to drop all the way. I think I'm pretty sure there's some trick to only drop. Huh? Why can't I equip the star sticks? Hmm? Really? You can't equip sticks? I never thought that can't be on it. Yeah, what's going on? Really? Huh? Completely forgotten about that. Okay. Yes. Sticks too mature. Not these particular clams, but this is an enemy type. Okay, that was a small key, I guess. No idea why we're supposed to use it. Shoot over there? I don't think so. Because I don't have the reach. Right, okay. Nice waste of time, but I guess that's just part of the dungeon. Didn't they have different symbols on them? I'm pretty sure this is the fixed version. The that they have like half moons, something like that. Maybe I'm confusing them with the time stones or Temple of Time stones. Let's see. Anything down there? Nope. Listen, I should keep the Lamp of Truth equipped. I don't think we actually need it in this dungeon, but. Or maybe there's one part. Oops. Just need to jump more accurately. Alright, I think these guys have switches in their mouths. These dragon dudes. Right. Not very much to. Nothing like pressure. Hook shot there. It's time to spin. It's time to move. Just get in there, take the shoes off. Damage boost. But yeah, these clams were definitely put in really shitty positions. Strategically placed. Now we have to. I guess let's drop a bomb there and drop down. Oops, kind of turned me around. Okay, that's it. Let's check out the bottom of the pool if there's anything of note. Nope, doesn't look like it. Stop playing with the horns. Ding. I think that's how they also did it. Oh, after the hookshot. Be way more convenient. Constantly changing menu. And changing equipment. Okay, I think that's where we can't go any. Oh, we can actually. Okay. Effortlessly pulls him. Ah, this is the part. Yeah, I think this is the part where he got stuck. Just swim over them. You don't have to fight them. Okay. Maybe I should try and find it on stream. land zone.
Yeah. Now you put your hand quickly through a flint.
Okay. Let's see if I can't get it on stream. Whoops. Screen capture. Yep. Flame.
Now you put your hand quickly through a flame.
Yeah.
Oh, these are the clams you're talking about.
I hate the clams.
Stop. Stop with the... Oh, no. Oh,
stupid clams.
Scary. Don't ever say that to a woman.
God fucking stupid clam!
Easy. Her name is Jennifer!
I hate clams.
You do not.
It's a fucking asshole! Fuck off, you fucking clam! Why won't it fucking God? It's so bullshit!
I think...
Just fuck- Ah! I hate it! Oh my God, now I'm dead! Because-
Let's go back to... There we go. Okay. Just want to show that. Is the sound maybe a bit too loud or just quiet? Then I'll turn it. No timer, that's good. Oops. I think we can just do a spin attack. Okay, I don't think there's anything else here. Just the sculpture. So he died for nothing, basically. Well, it's not for nothing, but you don't really need them. Oh, I can go in here, I haven't seen that. Oh yeah, this is a meme puzzle. I think this is another part of why people get stuck. There's a way down below this block, but you can't see it. You have to raise the water first and sink down here into this room. So that's really kind of mean. Because there's a good chance that you won't check out this part. Ouch. You have to backtrack a bit to get here. Or actually don't. Okay. So maybe that was just me and I'm projecting my own mistakes. Pretty sure you have to do that to solve the dungeon. And the cutscene shows the path. Okay, I'm just dumb. It's all me. Come on, I was like 8 years old, man. I'm pretty sure it also happened later. Let's see if we activate these things. It's gonna be clam zone. Oh no, and spike zone. Pretty cool. Valley, just use there. Shut up. Why are you being like this? What the hell's going on? I guess let's put it on another direction. Maybe right will work. That works. Wow, they explode with some force. Jeez, why does it work? Yes. It's been proved. Handsome. Wait, what the hell's going on? What bug is this? Maybe. Something's weird's going on with this game. I have noticed some bugs before, so this is said that already, but this is the PC version basically. The decompilation so that doesn't really work. I don't think we have to kill them actually, we can just... I hope so at least. Otherwise we're stuck. Something's up with the camera. Oh, very cool. There's nothing in play here. I guess we have to. But how are we gonna do that if we can't do anything underwater? The hookshot is my only. I have to hit him, trigger him somehow, and immediately shoot him. Okay, I'm gonna set the control. It won't target, it won't work, it doesn't work. For some reason he floats when he tries to pull out the hookshot. So I guess I have a bug report. Fast we're going. Why are we walking so fast? That's weird. So it can be done. I guess we have to approach from. There we go. Phew. Sorry that took so long, but game bug. Game is bugged. So. Clam battle. you miss that room, you would run around this temple and miss one key. And you would spend hours here. Which is a lot of fun. Okay. Can we reopen the exit for you or reopening? Okay, so it's not actually necessary for us. Let's just check out what we can do here. There's a 9. But I think we need the regular long shot, the regular hook shot. Let's check out what this is. Okay. Check out where this is. Ah, okay, so this is a section that's underwater usually. Bombs. Spikes. I mean, sorry, I'm not about to puke on stream. I'm just so amazed at the option design. Okay, let's go this way. Shot for. Yes. For entrance. This is where we went first. Where you go to the boss. Once you have the long shot. Okay, I guess let's go in. That's not what I wanted to see. Yikes. What did I miss? So maybe there's one extra key in the tower. Probably. That sucks, man. It's not this one, okay. This is where we got the pumpkins. I think I should have made a mistake by going out of the tower too soon. scarecrow. Nope. Would be convenient. So we have to go down. Do that entire nonsense again. Whoops, wrong about the room. Not gonna sleep 5 minutes, it's gonna take me longer. Some way of getting maybe backwards jumping. Okay, so what's that things? Nope, that's not it. What did I see up there? So we have to do like this strange arm thing. I'm not entirely sure how that works. Nope. Or I did it wrong. Central pillar, and then look, you can get to the third floor inside. Just reminding myself what I have to do. Shot for that. Actually, now that we have to, we can blow up that wall. That's also one thing we can do. Okay, we need the long shot for this. So that's probably not it. And let's see. There's a treasure. Nope. No, this isn't the thing that got us stuck. Because we have to sink down to the bottom again. Go right where we were. Nope, I don't think so. Nope, that's not it. Wrong exit. And this is probably it. Or is that the block puzzle? Okay. Let's just turn green. Okay. gizmo key. Okay. There we go. That was the second to last. Oh well, there's still some stuff to go. Now we go. back into the tower, I think. Now we go to the mini boss with the these water elevators. That was the now that we have the key. Just north of the mirror. Right? Nope. Let's just check every room. But I'm pretty sure we went into a door and you can immediately... Oh, there isn't another room, so it has to be the same. Okay, I just have bad memory. This one's in the back. Okay, thing. Come on, stop. This time, thank God. What the hell, man? Oh, this is actually fine. Let's hope it's fine. Thank you. this thing. It's just gonna piss me off. Okay. Now the Dark Link battle, which apparently on the Switch version looks terrible because some of the water shaders don't work, or transparency effects or reflection effects don't work properly. But this looks nice, so this is pretty cool. And we walk past. Oh, that's a cool transition. That's awesome. Okay, that's a long shot. This is for a whale. Oh yeah, okay. Let's play this. Something here. Oh. swim on all those. Oh yeah, that's touching that. Guess let's collect the hearts. Before. Okay. It's already solved. And now we want to put the water level down to level 2, I think, maybe, and get that eye switch. Shoot through with a long shot. I'm not sure where the water level is right now. Three, okay, so we have to go down. Again, wrong way. The one with the two torches, okay. I'm gonna try to remember it. The rumble. Well, you can really see, you can see that on the microphone thingy. Wow, that's intense. No one should trust this loud. Check out the sculpture. As well as switch the water level. Actually, we don't have to, right? Yeah, we can push the thing if we raise the water level, so I guess we should leave it where it is. Because we have to push a block. the end of this side path. I'm sorry, the rumble is very loud. Yes, let's try it. The option presents itself. Why not? Oh, that's fine. Okay. That's why not. Saved it just in time. Okay, let's open this door. The water level fixed. So far, I have lost 5 minutes or something because I went in a circle one time. But so far, it's going pretty good, pretty well. Usually, it takes a lot longer. For some reason I remember that very again. went through here. Where the boss. That's not it. That's the exit. So let's take a look here. Okay, nothing spectacular in here. What room did I miss? Let's check down there. Well, I'm pretty sure we've already checked down there. Or did we? Maybe not. That's one of the rooms that required a long shot. Okay, so that's another 3 minutes. There we go. Something with that area, spectrum. Otherwise, we just swim across. And I think we have to shoot all these. Let's shoot them all. Sounds like a monster or something. That's it. That's so nice. Hint. Oops. And I think this one can also be blown up. But the end is not as obvious. So let's see, where do we want to push it? Onto that button, okay. Finished Breaking Bad, but I put Better Call Saul on break. It's a good show, but didn't really grip me as much as Breaking Bad did. Breaking Bad already had some issues, so maybe I'm gonna keep watching it when I have time. Yeah. guess one of the things that are kind of weird is how inflated Mike's role is in the story. Because he, in the beginning, was just some dude who just happened to work there. But it just keeps getting... Oh, okay. Timed. Oh, I have to jump there. Or something in here. If you don't find this little nook, you're gonna be looking for hours. Thankfully I found it. Or that I remembered it. And there was something here. I guess now we can go through the door. Leave. Fight. Boss. Okay. Okay, so that didn't take that long actually. Bit over an hour. Considering I got stuck twice for a couple of seconds. That's not too bad. I think at least. So Mark Brown with has a podcast called Game Maker's Toolkit, where he discusses the designs of Zelda, or discuss the designs of Zelda dungeons, or just dungeons in general. And he said that this is a very well designed dungeon. And I kind of agree, but there's a lot of. Oh, I just have to run up there. There's a lot of factors that increase the frustration factor for no particularly good reasons, but I guess that's just an artifact of the time back then. So this guy froze everything despite being down here in a little pool. That's kind of weird. Let's just go with it. It's fine. It's fine. Just has to be. Ah, there's hookshot targets on the walls. Never even noticed those. Trick to lock him into the corner, but Inflatable tube man. Flaming arms, inflatable tube man. That's my choice. Okay. Very nice, very nice. That went pretty well, I'd say. Oh, okay. Because of the increased resolution or widescreen, the camera FOV bugs out a bit, but it's fine, it's fine. Okay. I think we can get the gold scale if we go back and do the swimming challenge again. Oh, we turned it off, I'm sorry. Sorry, I forgot, I didn't read. Tell that nothing will stop you in your quest for justice and peace. You must take the medallion, take it respectfully. Yeah. respectfully takes the medallion, tips hat. You receive the water medallion. Ruto awakens as a sage and adds her power to yours. The wife, if you see Sheik, please give him my thanks, okay? Maybe I should have added ice on this area too to make. No, that's fine. Okay. Oh yeah, we can get the fire arrows now. Since we're here. This is a weird cutscene. Oh yeah, the werewolf marks. Werewolf scratch on the tree. Where some guy just added it. Yeah, just put a scratch on there. Looks cool. I think there's like an interview with Miyamoto where he says he tells a story how he asks the employee why he would put some random rocks somewhere. The point of the interview was that he would basically only want things to be added that had to be added or that had a reason to be there. But I don't think that's actually true, and I don't think that would be a good thing if it were true. Sometimes this random shit is perfectly fine. So I still don't get why Navi does this green thing sometimes, for no discernible reason. He just has a little moment, I guess. Could do the swimming touched my Bluetooth earphones and they immediately start playing random sound files on my PC. It's still frozen down there. That's kinda shitty. Okay. Yes, we have two light. Maybe you call Pitipona here? Not actually sure. Yep, okay, that's cool. Technically, we could do the Icaron sword quest also, but I think you need the Zora King explosion for the frog, I think, for the items. So I think like that. Why do I remember some stuff so well and some some important stuff? Nah, what I want to say is, why do I remember some trivial stuff so well and some of the important stuff not so well? Critical. Pretty cool game information. Come on. It's okay. seething. So stupid. That's my own fault, I guess. My own fault. Oh, let's go troll hunting some other time. I wonder what they're actually named after. Are they named after Edgar Allan Poe? Why? Why would they be named that? There's a couple bad translations for names. Like the Iron Knuckle was supposed to be Iron Knight. Or Dark Knight, that's the one. Dark Knight is supposed to be Dark Knight. Iron Knuckle is, that's fine, I think that's what it actually says. Oh, not. I've also held a theory that Ganondorf is a really weird writing of Gandalf. Like Gandalf? Like Japanese organization of Gandalf, maybe? It wouldn't make much sense, but maybe they just picked a random name. Random fantasy name, basically. And Zelda is used as a Gandalf. Zelda was one of the American Nintendo of America dude's wife. Zelda Fitzgerald, I think? I'm not sure. No idea. And they just named the main character, one of the main characters of this series after her, for no particular reason. Huh? Isn't this. And freeze? Okay. Such shit memory. Jesus. So do I have to come here back as a kid and do a puzzle again or something? Aww. I guess it stays frozen. Okay. I guess we can start the
No, actually we can't.
That was a mistake.
Actually, I'm just acting a bit confused in general. Let's see what we can. So how does this work again? If we go to Kakariko right now, does the well thing break out? Let's not go. I guess I can look for the Desert Colossus. We have to go as an adult first to get the song and do the entire Gerudo Fortress. And for the Temple, I think you have to go the first as an adult and then as a child again.
And then that's another problem. So let's see if tragedy strikes. Yep. Oh no, the entire village is on fire. For a couple of minutes at least. And we let that thing out of the well, probably. That effect was kind of cool with the drifting along the walls shadow. Looks like you're coming around. Terrible thing has happened. The evil shadow spirit has been released. But the leader of Kakariko Village has sealed the evil shadow spirit in the bottom of the well. But the force of the evil spirit got so strong the seal of the well broke and it escaped into the world. I believe Impa has gone to the Shadow Temple to seal it again, but she will be in danger without any help. You will be in danger without any help. Okay. Impa is one of the six sages. Destroy the evil shadow spirit and save Impa. There is an entrance to the shadow temple beneath the graveyard behind this village. This village is haunted. The only thing I can do for you is teach you the melody that will lead you to the shadow temple. This is the melody that will draw you into the infinite darkness that absorbs even time. Listen to this, the nocturne of shadow. Like you have a spider curse, you have the end of the well with his weird zombies and skeletons, and you have the graveyard with Dumpy and the shadow temple. This entire place is haunted. Take care of the village, I'm counting on you. There we go. Snap. I don't think I've found the shadow temple before the desert colossus before. This would be the first time, I guess. This would be a try. Oh yeah, the reason you want to come here as a kid is because there's something up there. Oh, which is the workshop? Okay. think we can just use Jin's fire. Right. That's always been a bit weird. That this particular part required a spell. Alright, actually I'm not sure if you can do it without spell. Just with fire arrows maybe. And we're in the Shadow Temple. Is the music different? Oh no, it isn't. Okay. Now we want bombs and this. Pretty sure we have to get the shoes first. Shadow Temple, where the secrets of Hyrule, or the bloody secrets of Hyrule, are hidden or something. Saying there we go, as though I managed to beat some hard boss or something. Everything in this game is pretty easy. I don't think there's anything that's magically hard. No traction. So when I was like 8, I would put these shoes on and never take them off, despite them being kind of shit. I had like the mindset that if they're an item that you'd get, then surely they are an upgrade. So I guess I keep them forever. No matter how much I hold this slide around. So this puzzle, I think one of those has a skull, this one, and that's why you have to push this thing, the raven statue. Interestingly enough, the head thing on the other side of the hole, not hole, of the abyss thing, right behind us that you can see has the same design as the... what's going on? What's going on? Oops, what goes? Come on, I forgot what I wanted to do. It's this thing. Okay, you have to wait a second. I guess that's merciful. So this statue, I really need to learn just how to speak English. This thing looks like that fountain in the bottom of the well. Same design. Always thought that was kind of cool. But I guess they're just the same dungeon village. Not really anything special. Another thing that got me stuck, that you can blow these up, or this one, the one on the left that I just blew up, these other two you can blow it through. That's just stupid design decision. Well, it isn't stupid, but it got me stuck, which is why I say it's stupid. Oh yeah. Shot onto that thing. Sorry if I do some stupid things while solving these puzzles, because just the much some things, but not much. Should have checked the ground actually before I went in here. On the sword. Frozen sword. Not actually essential. So this is where Let me talk. Nope. Yep, shadows on the PC one. Cool. Jar Jar Binks eats in episode 1, is that what it's called, a loopy? Or is that the bunny that he has to paint? I don't know. Saying I remember this stuff, but there's not really much else you can do except use the ends of truth. That's definitely what I'm talking about. Dropping spike traps. Kind of like the king of colonists. With his saw blades. Billions of saw blades. I like it when they rationalize silly. Rationalize game design. By saying it's a personality quirk. That's kind of mean, putting these collectibles in dungeons. Like, in dungeons. Over there and kick our ass, but then you'd have to walk a couple steps. Made of my own. Here. level something up in here. Spirits. Those who have sacred food should let the wound guard them when they die. Okay. Sacred feet. This was what? Oh, here's where we have to blow something up. So the rumbling, I hope it's not too loud in the recording. Wow, what an opposite. Something weird about the jump attack. Kills them in one hit, but the spin attack takes 4 minutes, so that's kind of weird. Okay, I'm gonna have to swap out my headphones. Wait a second. I think you can hear it now. I'm gonna have to check. Okay, can you hear? Probably heard a bit of the Star Trek episode I was watching. Whatever. I wonder what they were talking about. Didn't hear anything. No spoilers, please. Shortcut. Oh yeah, some sculptures are invisible if I look like me. Right? No? Right? Huh? Okay, I guess not. Getting kinda thirsty. Okay, I just poured in a glass of tea while pushing that block and climbing up the ladder, but I don't really know. Oh, no. So this is when we can play the Scarecrow song, I think. Not sure. Like, why not? What the hell, man? That's too bad, huh? Fine. If we just go like this. Mm-hmm. I always thought this section was kind of cool, despite it being kind of really short and not that impactful, but it's... yeah, boat to the underworld, basically. Up with the mini-map, by the way. This is a completely different room. I guess let's go around in a counterclockwise fashion. Oh, that's the exit. And they're back. I guess let's just ignore them. Let's just ignore them. One-off rooms. Unmemorable. Huh? Oh, it's very specific. Only this fire spell works. The other one, for some reason, doesn't. Maybe it's bugged. Nope. Okay, I think there's nothing else in this room. Can't be missing a little bomb throw mini game in the dark dungeon. The dark eternal darkness dungeon. Quite as unfair. I'm blowing up all of these little piles in the corner, ship piles in the corner. Was it like one small key? Geometry. I think I may have not activated the scarecrows. Maybe you have to talk to them as an adult after teaching them the song. Okay. Nothing else, just walk this. I guess we need the boots. Me off the cliff. So if you have the frost arrows at this stage, you can freeze his hands, and he has a special animation for that. That's all. That's awesome. I never had the ice arrows at this stage, but cool detail. Gross hands. Weird next stop. Yeah. I should deactivate. Something is like some kind of decapitation thing. I don't know. I don't think the devs were that edgy when they made this. They just wanted to make a cool design. They did. I don't think so. Okay, so it's getting kind of late. I think I'm gonna call it here. Thanks for checking by. I'm gonna let this cutscene play. Then I'm gonna call it for tonight. I never really noticed that knife on her backside. It's like, I already said that last stream, like a Tanto knife. I'm Impa, one of the Sheikah. I'm Princess Zelda's caretaker and also the sage who Shadow Temple. We Sheikah have served the royalty of Hyrule from generation to generation as attendants. However, on that day 7 years ago, Ganondorf suddenly attacked, and Hyrule Castle surrendered after a short time. Ganondorf's target was one of the keys to the Sacred Realm, the hidden treasure of the royal family, the Ocarina of Time. My duty bound me to take Zelda out of Ganondorf's reach. When last I saw you, as we made our escape from the castle, you were just a lad. Now I see that you have become a fine hero. There's nothing to worry about. The princess is safe now. Soon you'll meet Princess Zelda face to face and she will explain everything. That is when we, the six wise ones, will seal up the evil king and return peace to Hyrule. I have to stay here. You go to Princess Zelda's side and protect her on my behalf. Now I put my power, which should be helpful to you, into this medallion. Except it doesn't really have any powers, we just collect them because they look pretty. Shiny coins. Please look out for the princess. Yep. Okay. So. Again, thanks for coming by. Save. There we go. And see you soon. See you around. Have a good one. Okay, bye.